I wish you could turn this sideways.
Easy. I thought we had to throw a series up. Thank you.
morning.
Good morning.
Make sure everyone's got their communion cups for communion here later. Remember that, just that we may have mass for mandatory at this time. There's no singing or responsive reading. Also, youth groups canceled until the 10th. Christmas Eve services at present, Christian First will be at 4 o'clock and Correction Bill at 6. And remember to bring either your own LED candles or you can use your cell phone. We won't be passing out candles or flashlight. Please not the big one that you use to check the cows with, though. I say somebody's got one of those spotlights, right? Bible study this week is on Tuesday, but the next week it'll be back on Monday. And then Jingle in the Jog is this coming Friday and Saturday. And are we doing it? Is it going to be here Saturday, this Friday evening? Also, are there any other announcements? Yeah, we have council meeting Wednesday night at 7 or 7:30. I was trying to move it a little earlier since we don't have any announcements going on. Are there any other announcements? So we'll be at 7:30. All right, food pantry this week. With that, we'll begin to have our organs choice.
Came to Nazareth, where he had been reared. As he always did on the Sabbath, he went to the meeting place. When he stood up to read, he was handed the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it was written, "God's Spirit is on me. He's chosen me to preach the message of good news to the poor. He sent me to announce pardon to prisoners and recover his sight to the blind, to set the burden and battered free, to announce, this is God's year to act." Luke 4:16-19. This scripture, written by Luke, according to Lanisha Rouse, is one of the most profound passages portraying Jesus as liberator. At the synagogue, Jesus appropriated the prophecy of Isaiah 61 as a call to what his ministry on earth would be. Then he came to preach good news to the poor, in whatever form that took, be it economically, socially, physically, or mentally. Just as this was Jesus' mission, we too are sent to offer words that heal, empower, and liberate. Jesus sets us free so that we may live life with joy and be lighters to those in need of his love and hope. So how can we be a light bearer to someone who is struggling this season? Come, Lord Jesus, as we await your coming anew at Christmas, we yearn for release from all our fears. Give us a sense of your liberating, challenging love. In your name we pray. Amen. Let us sing that Advent candle song, verses 1 and 2.
We are.
share our joys that we have for this week, or have seen, if you have, ways you have seen God working this week. We're going to be talking about today, about sharing those as part, as what Pam was saying, being the light for those in our community. So, we have times that they have seen Jesus at work in their community. Yes, thank you. Praise God for that. More joys. Yes. More joys to share? Yes, it is. Getting better. Baby found out they're pregnant, and the church is beautiful. More joys to share today. The things you have seen that God has done. As we've lifted up our put our offerings into play, doxology as a way of celebrating those offerings. Scripture readings for today. Our first one comes from Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 through 11. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins, they shall raise up the former devastations, they shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. Still, strangers shall stand and feed your flocks. Foreigners shall till your land, dress your vines. But you shall be called priests of the Lord. You shall be named ministers of our God. You shall enjoy the wealth of our nation, of the nations, and in their riches you shall glory. The shall be theirs. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the people. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he hath clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robes of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. Our gospel reading comes from Luke chapter 16, or chapter 4, verses 16 through 22, and this is the story of the rejection of Jesus of Nazareth. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed upon him. Then he began to say to them, "Today the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." All spoke well of him, and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They said, "Is not this Joseph's son?" The word of God for the people of God. Praise be to God. Located in modern-day Turkey. it was sometime around 380, and there were three sisters who were being forced into becoming slaves because their parents could not afford a dowry for each girl to get married. The girls were going to have to work for various men around Patara to earn enough money to be accepted into another family in marriage. Well, Nicholas knew that what kind of slavery it was, and that he did not want to see these girls forced into this kind of life. So he took his own money. Oh, by the way, did I mention that St. Nicholas came from a wealthy family in Patara? Well, he did. And he took his money and left three sacks of gold on the window ledge by the girls' bedroom. He made a sacrifice to free these girls from a life that would have probably been their deaths. Nicholas did this because he knew this is what Jesus did for him. Freed him from a life that would have been death for him. A life that was not healthy for him. In our Bible study today, Pastor Lanicia Rouse tells the story of her mentally handicapped friend, Ms. Ruby. Ms. Ruby helped Lanicia in her ministry to the homeless in Houston, Texas. She does it still today. Lanicia says this of Ms. Ruby: "I was most captivated by Ms. Ruby's ability to see Jesus in each of the guests and their ability to see Jesus in her. Her loving spirit brought a smile of joy to each face. She moved around the room freely, offering her presence and compelling with authenticity, acceptance, and unconditional love. It was compelling. Equally as compelling were the kindness, respect, and acceptance the guests extended to Ruby." She went on to say that on about one occasion, when Miss Ruby turned to a guest who had just finished singing a Christmas song with her and said, "I love you, Jesus," he looked at her and said, "I love you too, Miss Ruby." That next day, Lanicia and Ruby, and this day happened to be Christmas, they saw three men near the church. Well, Ruby saw them while as Lanicia was focused on driving. Ms. Ruby, through her gift, she called out, "Buddy," that's what she called Lanicia, "Jesus, Jesus is there. See Jesus?" Jesus was there. Jesus was with those men, Jesus was there with Ms. Ruby and Lanicia. What St. Nicholas and Ms. Ruby have in common is their way they see Jesus. Both see Jesus outside of the norm of their day. Nicholas saw Jesus in the three bags of gold he left for those young women. Those bags would lead to their freedom from the slavery of prostitution. Those three bags represented that somebody cared about them. Ms. Ruby saw Jesus in the people she met. She saw Jesus as their liberator and as her liberator. Maybe not necessarily from their physical circumstances, but as receiving freedom from the reality they were living in. Freedom to have hope that God knows and cares about them. That God really does love those men on the street. That he does love Lanicia and Ms. Ruby. And that God loves you and I. That he loves us so much, he brought us the means to be free. Remember, Jesus is there and here. He calls us daily to see what he is doing in the world. He calls us to recognize those moments, to share those moments with others. We are called to not only be part of those moments, but to be the hands and feet of Jesus. But we are also called to give thanks and celebrate those moments when we do see Jesus at work in the world. That is what sharing our joys is all about. Where have you seen Jesus at work? In fact, that part of the service should be the longest part of the service. We should not spend only 10 minutes doing joys. This should last 20 to 30 minutes. Or if not longer. We should really have something that we would like, love, or cannot wait to share about where we saw Jesus at work in our lives this past week. Even those of you online should have something to share about where you have seen Jesus, and don't be afraid to write them in the comments. In fact, I'd like to see the comments blowing up on my, as I can see the scroll. Your sharing of those moments could be what somebody needs for this week to help them realize that Jesus really is at work in the world. That God really does care and wants to see us all free from a reality that keeps us from experiencing true hope and love. Let me close with these words from Lanicia Rouse. I find hope every day in the gospel message that what is done, though it does not have to be, and that in Jesus we see marked out for us a life full of goodness, justice, mercy, peace, forgiveness, and love. On the darkest days, we can still find light in people and the world around us, often in the most unexpected places and moments. When we open our eyes and look for Jesus, understand his mission, and join him where he is dwelling, we will see people and places that are pregnant with new life. What a great privilege it is to be loved by and in service with a Creator who chose to be with us, who refused to remain distant, who came in Christ so that we might be truly free. I want you to remember these words. Christ came so that we may be truly free. And continue to look for Jesus in our communities. Look for Jesus in our family, our friends, and strangers. Be the light and share those moments with all of us, because you are a light bearer to someone who may be struggling with seeing Jesus themselves this season, because Jesus sets us free. Oh, kids, you missed it. I don't know if you've heard, some of you, down in Sunday school. You know what today is? Since we get today, in some churches, today is the day they give presents. In some of the Christian denominations. Back, he's a real person, and what he did was save three girls from harm by giving them gold. And that's where the story of giving presents came from. Well, what concerns do we have to lift up today? We killed your dad back at Cherokee, is that? More concerns to lift up?
Let's just keep praying for the pandemic and all people who fall ill in the world.
Yeah. Continue to keep those in prayer who are suffering from this the pandemic. Not just with the illness, but due to job closures and struggling just with the season of loneliness. And more concerns? Are lift up? Faye.
Pink House.
Well, let us pray. Gracious and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the joys we receive, for finding for a new discovered pregnancy, for recovery, and for this beautiful week that we have. As we celebrate these joys, we also lift up our concerns. Continue to be with Rachel's dad as he recovers. Be with those who are suffering this pandemic, not just from the illness itself, but for those who are grieving, for those who have lost jobs, who are isolated, and for the disruption in life that it has caused in this season. Be with the family of Faye as they grieve her passing. With Hayden's family as they continue to grieve this tragic passing for his family. These things we ask through your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And now let's pray as Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It's hard not to do that. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, and we give our thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remains steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets, who looked for that day in which justice shall roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. When nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he Son Jesus Christ, whom you sent in the fullness of time to be a light to the nations. You scatter the proud in the imagination of their hearts, and mercy on those who fear you from generation to generation. You put down the mighty from their thrones and exalt those of low degree. You fill hungry with good things, and with the rich you send away, you send empty away. Your own Son came among us as a servant to be Emmanuel, your presence with us. He humbled himself in obedience to your will and freely accepted death on a cross. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts of Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine, and make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Because there is one wafer, we who are many are one body. For we all partake of the one loaf. The bread which we break is the sharing of the body of Christ, and the cup which we give thanks is the sharing of the blood of Christ. And at this time, you may take the body and the blood of Christ, and take your time of prayer as Denise lifts up some meditation. Faithful God, you have adopted us as your children, made us members of the body of Christ, and chosen us as inheritors of your kingdom. We thank you that at your table you renew our promises within us, empower us to be your spirit, to witness and to serve, and send us out as disciples of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For those who tell that on the insight into where you would have us go and what you would have.